My name is Dadara. I'm an artist. I live in Amsterdam. And yeah, it's difficult to explain what I do because I don't do one particular thing. I make paintings, I make installations, theater plays. It can be like all kind of stuff. And I think it's also difficult to talk about yourself, what you're doing. People often ask you, like, what's the medium you work in or you prefer to work in? And my favorite medium is mindfuck. I think for me, free spaces were really important, or are still really important, but especially when I just started out and I was getting kicked out from a lot of art academies, and I was 18, 19, and I was figuring out who I am. And then people told me, like, yeah, you can now live like chaotic, wild, whatever, and not be irresponsible, but you'll need to grow up. And then I went for the first time to a place like Ruighoort, and I saw all these people that were like in their 50s and 60s, and they were definitely not grown up, but they were like really doing something they believed in. And I went like, hey, this is possible. And I think it's important, especially at a young age, but I think at every age, when you see there are different options to live your life. And one of the options that nowadays seems to be prevalent in a city like Amsterdam, it's just like, you need to get a good job, make money and be part of the system. And it is an option. If you want to do that and you believe in it, it's fine. But there are more options, and I think it's very important that it's visible, that you can live in different ways. And I also just think it's very important that you've got places to experiment, and especially maybe places that are not perfect and are not finished yet. They're not ready, they're not perfect, they're a work in progress. What I noticed most is that you look at the spaces where all these parties were happening, and everything was not defined yet. They were very much open spaces, and I think it's very important that you have spaces in a city which are not defined, where everything is possible and it's not yet ready, it's not finished. So there's space for you to think, like, what do I want to do to really participate instead of just consume. Yesterday we had a discussion about free spaces, and a friend of mine, Arthur, who used to be a banker, he was there as well, and he said the difficult thing is that now very much banks, but also the economy, the society is very much looking at short term. Like, what's the short term value? What will we get out of this next month? When can we present to our shareholders? And they want immediate value. But I think what's very important is, and companies, they have like a research and development department, and a city needs that as well to, in order to grow, to define itself. You have the so-called underground, you have stuff where things are happening and it's not clear what their value will be. Their value will probably just be proven like in 10 years time. And it's so important to understand that not everything can just be proven now. It should not happen, but house prices are rising. There is less and less space. And I think it's very important that not just only the artists and the people from free spaces understand what its value is, because then it's us against them. And you go like, yeah, we need to have this. But I also believe in, it's somehow, for me, why I'm a real city person. I love cities. And why do I love them? Because there are all these different kind of people coming together, and they somehow are forced to live together, work together. And I think that's where chemistry can happen. And everybody can develop themselves, because I don't develop myself when I'm just surrounded by people who are the same like me. So this diversity, but even in nature, monoculture does not work. And so a free space bridge the gap between them and so-called real society, or the bankers, the tech people, the people in charge, and where it's clear that it's like yin-yang, when you can't have black without white, and it's clear for everybody that in a city you need all these different cultures. And how can you find the space? It's real space, but also space in your mind to make this happen. And I think that's a real challenge where everybody needs to come together. We need free spaces, but free spaces are somehow also confined and are like on the outskirts of town now. But I think what's maybe as important is to turn Amsterdam more and more into a free space, and also have artists do stuff in public space, because public space is free space. It's not just space where you can hang up advertisements. I mean, that's one option, but it's our space as well.